Hey everybody, Scout Crafty here again. It's Friday, TGIF. You made it through another week. And I have to tell you, if this 2021 is supposed to be a lot better than last year, I'm not feeling it yet. I'm on a full media blackout. That's right, I am. It was like I was transported back from 50 years ago. I do not watch anything recent on television news. I am on a full blackout. In fact, this morning, sometimes I put the radio on before I go into the shower. Today, I just right into an old Jack Benny episode, which is very good. I'll put the link in a comment. Jack Benny was great, I'll tell you. And I had me laughing out loud. And I said, when was the last time a regular listening to the radio had you laugh out loud? So that's Jack Benny's the man. So anyway, today, every couple months, I do a thank you for the people that sent some things into the show, and that's what we're going to do today. So there'll be no restoration, but I want to show you some of the things that people sent in, and then after I show you, it goes up into the to-do area upstairs, which is pretty much packed full, so it's going to be a while. But in no particular order, let me show you some of the things that some of the subscribers sent in. And thank you so much for that. Let me show you what we got. Okay, first off, a good friend of the show by the name of Joel Jacobson from McLean, Virginia, sent in this nice batch of hardware, door hardware, and antique vintage. Now, the funny thing is, for a lot of you, this might seem like antique, and this is all the stuff that's in my house now. And the funny thing is, all the lock pickers out there that are so good with picking locks, this is the kind of locks that I have on all the inside doors of my house, you know. So, you know, they come with their little lock pick set, and you can't really do anything with these because it's a whole different kind of mechanism. They use the old-fashioned skeleton keys. They're meant to last for 100 plus years, and they're serviceable. You could take the thing apart, and you know, this is what I have in the inside doors of my house. Also, another nice feature, like these are door plates that they used to put around the locks, and I just chipped off a little piece here. Now, if you look, you could see that the paint is beautiful because it protects it, so they're not rusted. But what happens is you take this down, you wire brush it, you give it a primer, and you spray it black like this, and it's good for another 100 years. And it's very ornate, and it stops the key from... they used to have the smaller ones, the round ones, that would put around the key. But this is a little bit more ornate, and for a certain type of... These are the old ceramic... doorknobs, but I have the glass ones upstairs in my house. But these are always nice because these clean up really nice too. And look at the ornate, how all even the doorknobs are so nice compared to later on, like in the 70s, they went to this type, you know, which is, you know, it's nothing like this, right? This is just beautiful. Look at all that ornate design, and they were bronze, or they were, you know, colored in different ways. And of course, these hinges. Now, these hinges use door pins, things like that. And believe it or not, they're steel hinges, but they're brass plated. And obviously made in the USA here. It says this one's National Manufacturing Company. And these were meant to last a lifetime, you know. Sometimes they would squeak a little bit, a drop of oil, that's all you needed. So, Joel, thanks so much for these. This is just still what I use in my house today. Next up, a good friend of the show, Andrew Taylor, from all the way in the UK, from Buckinghamshire, in the UK. And he sent us these nice two things. Look at this BSA wrench. And it's funny because it's like an open ring wrench, but it looks like it was... you know, made how they cut the ends, right? How, and it is a, you see it fits four different sizes here. Never seen one of these in the UK, in the United States before, but you could see BSA. And he sent this lock. And what's interesting about this lock, it was on his garden shed for, he said, like, let me show you how quickly this cleans up. And just like that, 15 minutes later, and a trip to the wire brush, and look how nice this lock comes out. Now, this is a Squire lock. They still make this lock today. And this is the model 220, you could see here. And these are just beautiful locks because they're so simple, yet they do the job they're intended to. Now, what happens is with this particular key here, you could see there's a little, I lubricated it extensively, but you put the key in here and you see it comes through the back here like this, and you turn it to the right once and it opens up this lever. You could see it's a very simple lock, and to close it, you would just turn the key the other way, and now it's locked. And again, they are, you know, they do the job. They are,
you know, for, they're hard to pick, believe it or not. These aren't as easy to pick as you might think from the type of key, but they aren't easy to pick, and they do have resistance because they are made strong, you know, but again, it's a riveted lock, and it's made, and he used to have it on his shed for like 20 years, so I always like these type locks because of the fact that they're still made the same way they were back in the 1800s, this Squire. But special thanks to Andrew, his wife Laura, and daughter Lizette. And really appreciate it over there in the UK. Next up, last month when our friend Brian Burns, he's from Round Lake, Illinois, he saw the Miller's Falls knife and he said, I got some blades, I'm going to send you. And sure enough, he sent me original Miller's Falls blades. We're going to run this through the fiber wheel to get some of the staining, but these are the original blades and they're in great shape, and that'll go good with the original Miller's Falls. And then he also sent me this Irwin blade. He swears by these. Brian says that he uses a lot of blades, and he says these really hold up good, so we'll give that a shot. Brian, thanks so much for that. Next up, a good friend of the show, Terry Fortley from Santa Rosa, California, sent in this package. And I got to tell you something, there's all kinds of cool stuff here. You know, you really have to sit there and look. He just, and it came in a flat rate box, you could see, and he just sent this stuff like the coolest. This is an actual pinball from a pinball machine. You know, it's like he had a story behind it. It's like a special hardened, it's more than 52-100. They were specially made for the pinball machines, and all kinds of stuff, and really cool. You have to just sit here, and I was looking through this stuff. I love hardware, as you know. Look at this little miniature bench vise, you know. This would go on here, and you could see here, it well, goes like this here. It's like a miniature vise, a working vise, too. You could see it works. And, you know, homemade scraper. Look at this. Somebody made this homemade, beautiful little scrapers, a nice crescent 4-inch adjustable, and all just, and you know how these clean up. We're going to do this part, but you see this one here? These are Bernards, and they look like, you know, Bernards. Whenever they come like this, you say, oh, geez. These clean up so nice with just the wire brush, and all kinds of, you know, clamps, things like this. And this is looks like a bronze, but these are the clamps. Usually, like, machinists use these to stop the carriage or carriage stops or different dial indicator holders, and they use them for all different things. Nice switches here, toggle switch. Who doesn't love a toggle switch? Look at this. This I thought was pretty cool. He sent a couple of these door locks or whatever that you would call them, you know, that would close a door. But what I found interesting about this, besides it coming with all the hardware and everything you need, look at the cool plans. National Brass Company, Grand Rapids, Michigan. Look at the cool plans that somebody drew up to show how this would go onto your door using this handle here. You see? Using this handle here, and just beautiful, huh? You know, it's got the striker, it's got the push pin, and just, and it's all included. They're NOS, but just how cool is that, that they came with the plans like that? Indicator lights, who doesn't love these things, you know? That's for my robot build, and just great stuff. What can I say? Terry, thank you so much. All kinds of cool stuff here that I just, you know, you can look through and figure out what is all this stuff. And there's just so much cool stuff here. New old stock Secret Service padlock. Yeah, who doesn't love this stuff? Again, Terry, thanks so much. Appreciate it. Okay, next up, this is pretty exciting. A longtime friend, a really long, by the name of Brian Little. And Brian comes from Marion, Iowa. And, you know, he's been, again, leaving comments for years. And Brian turned a few years ago to these type screwdrivers, to they're called JIS, or Japanese Industrial Specification Screwdrivers. Now, I first heard about these when I was restoring one screwdriver. Really never heard about it. Apparently, the guys in Europe have been using these for a long time. They're just getting big here in the U.S. and stuff. And Brian found these, and he says, forget, he's this is it. This is all he does anymore. If you see the jaws, this is like a magnification of the jaws, you could see here, but they have a toothed area, so, and that's so that these screwdrivers do not cam out of a Phillips. He says once you go to using these, you don't go to, you're done, you get rid of your other screwdrivers. That's how good these are. And let me tell you, I could tell right now this handle material is beautiful. It's that hard, it's like a super tough poly almost like a Delrin, it feels like. You know, it's not that spongy stuff that gets corroded and soft and tacky and leaves that thing on you. These are nice handles. A lot of them have the striking caps on the back, the heavier duty ones here. And they have, you know, the magnetic tip if you want. You see some of these do. And look at this one. Look how small that tip is, huh? Can you see that? That thing is micro. But these are just beautiful. And then he sent a couple of driver tips for the guns. And he also sent the catalog. Now, let me show you this catalog, because I really love
this. I love a good catalog, and it seems like today that a lot of catalogs are junk. And this catalog here, first of all, it's full color. I love that. Secondly, they take advantage of it, and everything is explained simply. And, you know, it's so nice to look at something, and it sells you. It's like a sales brochure. Every one of these things tell you exactly how the screwdriver works, how the bit works, and it gives you a full explanation. And that's the way all catalogs should be. I don't know what happened that catalogs turned to crap over the last so many decades, but this is just beautiful because everything that they offer in here, look at this one here for when you're driving, and it even has a spring mechanism in there with a cam mechanism. It's like their impact driver, but with a screwdriver. And you know, the one thing nice about Japanese stuff, anybody that knows tools knows that when Japan makes something, they don't go halfway. They really make it nice. And again, as their catalog shows, that they have all kinds of products, but I really appreciate this because I've never seen, I really don't have any vessel tools, never heard of them before. And this is a real eye opener, and I can't wait to try these out. They just feel so good in the hand. They have the little hex over here that you can put a wrench on if you have to torque it a little bit extra. And again, that tip on there. So I'm excited to see how they work. Brian swears by him. He's been doing work like that for many years. One other thing he sent, Brian, which is pretty cool, knows I like scissors and shears. And he sent these. He said his wife is able to dull out any shear within within weeks. But he says this one here really holds. She can use without dulling out. So it's kind of a testimony. So let's open this up.
Okay, I cut off that the edge of this clamshell packaging with a pair of Wiss shears, and here we go. Wow, look at these, huh? And he says they're easy to sharpen, that you can take them apart because they have the nut, comfortable in the hand. And let's give it a shot on one of his papers here. Take a look here. Wow, can you hear that? Is there something satisfying about about a really sharp scissor? Because I find it really, especially when it's sharp all the way through and you don't have to torque it. You know how sometimes with dull scissors, you got to torque it with your hand. You got to push your thumb this way and you pull your, this is nice. These are nice. I could tell just the way they operate. And I'll be using, I'll be looking, these are going upstairs. I won't be murdering these in the shop. These are going to go in my kitchen where I use a lot of scissors anyway. But Brian, thanks so much. These are really nice. They are the model number here, 48, 22, 40, 41, and he swears by them. He's been using them for a long time. Brian, thanks so much. Okay, next up, we're getting into more recent stuff. My good friend Tom T-Rex, you know, Tom hasn't put out a video in a while, and I know he's been busy. He's been doing all kinds of stuff, but I met Tom at the Kent show. My girlfriend and I were there, and Tom was there with his wife, and let me tell you, great guy, funny guy, and the funny thing is, Tom does all kinds of stuff. I mean, he's a handyman. He does hydroponics. If you go on his page, you see everything he does. It's just amazing. And he does custom designs and stuff. He did for Resto Rob. He did beautiful things and stuff. But he sent me, check this out, and I don't think Tom even knew, but he sent me, Tom makes close pins. These are homemade clothespins. Let me show you these, how nice.
Okay, I had to wash my hands. I didn't want to make sure I didn't get to mess up Tom's beautiful clothespins.
Now, let me tell you something. One thing I know that Tom didn't know, and that a lot of you, that I have actually a collection of antique clothespins that I've been, you know, for years. I have all different, I must have 30 different styles. You know, the clothespin has been reinvented so many times. They've been trying to find a better design, but this actual design is probably the, not only the most popular, but the best working clothespin. But I have all different types, from wood all the way up to plastic, and
all different sizes, shapes, but look how beautiful these are. And a lot of people don't realize what goes into making a clothespin and how, you know, with the lines in the back here for the grip so it don't slip out, and the straight grain wood and the spring mechanism and how it seats in here. It's an invention that we take for granted, but years ago everybody used a clothespin. I don't know today, I don't know how much they used as much, but a good old-fashioned clothespin is a few artisans that are making them today, and people like an old-fashioned clothespin that works. If you buy those overseas, I don't know what kind of wood they're made of or something. They're horrible. The springs aren't right. They twist when you squeeze them. These stay straight when you squeeze. It's just, they're great. So he did a fantastic job on that. But probably the coolest thing he sent was one of his designs. Look at this. He sent me some stickers. And I never had any stickers. Look at this. Scout Craft to Patina Patrol. I want to put this on my truck. And I just hope my windows don't get broken from the Patina boys. But how cool is that? With the Adventure Team logo on the back and the Patina Patrol. So definitely cool. And again, Tom, thanks so much. I know we'll be meeting up again at the next show in Connecticut because we're all dying to go. But you got to check out Tom's channel. I'll put a link in the description if you haven't seen it. He put an engine on a on a wagon. You got to see some of the stuff he does. Anyway, Tom, thanks so much. I really appreciate it. Okay, last up, this is probably the most recent package I received, and this comes from my good friend John Crane out on he's in Washington, the state of Washington. You came from New Jersey years ago, but we've already reviewed John's channel. John has a fantastic channel, and he's a jack of all trades, does everything. Have to go check him out if you haven't already. Right On with John Crane is his channel. But let me show you, before my hands get dirty, I want to show you the first thing. He sent me one of his bags. Now, John must have been a tailor at some time because he did what a beautiful job on this bag. This is a general purpose bag, and it's just made so nice. Between the inside here, the beautiful, the tent cloth, they call this, and the stitching is just perfect. And if you ever done any kind of stitching, you really appreciate it. And the zipper is just so beautiful, the type of, it's like a tent zipper that he used. It's just really nice. And everything that he did, the seams, and there's no, from inside, everything looks perfect. It's just, what a beautiful job on these. He actually sells these bags. He also sells, he has tool rolls, things like that. You got to go over to his website and check it out. But this is just such a beautiful bag. We'll be bringing this one to Jacktown to show it off. But let me show you what else he sent. Now, he is a big fan of Hardwick & Sons. Hardwick & Sons was in business since 1932. They recently were closing down. So he went in there. He's been going there for a long time. But he went there and he purchased a few tools and things like that before just to have as a keepsake. And he sent a couple over here. This one here is a Stanley push drill here. And you remember these. These always clean up nice. They always work well. This is going to be a great project. He picked up this. This is made by Woolworth. See here? Woolworth. And it's a made in the USA. It's a Stilson wrench. And it's a nice one. A little small one. Really, it's a high-quality one, just missing the knurled ring. We'll have to find that. This is another nice thing. But here is the cat's pajamas that he sent in. Now, I have a couple, you know, breast drills hanging around, literally hanging around. I am a fan of breast drills, and when I first started doing restorations, actually, this is what I started doing was breast drills, and this is the Cadillac of breast drills. And let me tell you about, this is a Yankee, and let me show you a little bit about how this works. This one particular one, this is Asgon from John, the way he sent it, because he knows that we like to do it up here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lubricate it just a little bit so that I can demonstrate how this works. Just do it. Okay, I just want to give you a quick demo of this drill. I know we're running a little long on the video, but you have to see how great this drill is. This was Yankee's flagship line. And you can see here, it says a Yankee number 555 was the model of this. And what it was a ratcheting breast drill. They called it a breast drill because you would hold this plate against your chest and operate it that way. And you could see here, And I put a spade bit in here just so you could see the revolutions here. Now, it had multiple positions, okay? If you look over here, there's a ratcheting lever up here that if you put it on the bottommost position here, that's the lock position, and that's so you can get the bit in and out, and you don't have to worry. You just lock it up, and you could tighten up the bit. When you go to the first position here, just one click up. Here, let me turn it so you can see what it says. It lists down exactly which each one is. It'll say, and it's going to be a little hard to see, but it'll say right hand double. The next one is right hand, and the one above that is left hand ratchet, and the one above that is plane. Let me show you what each one does. We have it in right hand double speed now. So what that means is, here's your handle here. As I rotate it, you're watching the bit up front. As you rotate it, it's going normal. But when I go backwards, it also rotates to the right. So look, see what I'm doing? Forward or backward, the bit is spinning the same exact way. How great is that? Secondly, let's go to the next one. Next one is right hand. Okay, now when I turn it this way, it's a ratcheting. So in other words, it free spins on the back pull, but it ratchets forward. And people that have used auger bits know how important it is to have these little accessories here. Next up, we have the left hand, okay? Left hand ratchet. Now, that is if you have to get something stuck and you got to get that bit out. Again, you could do this. You can, and it's going to the left if you're trying to get that bit out of the wood. And it free spins in the forward motion. And last up is the standard. If you push this all the way up here, like that, it acts like a regular bit. You see? Forward, reverse, just like a regular bit. Now, over here is another gearbox in here. Now, if I flip this lever down, I want you to look. First, let me get it over here to put it down here to the right-hand double. And I want you to look at the RPMs of the auger bit up front here, okay? Now, I'm spinning it at this normal speed. Look at the RPMs as I'm spinning it like this, you see? Now I'm going to flip this lever here, this one, flip it to the downside. Now watch, it gears up. Look, it doubles the speed. This is just amazing. This was so far. This is 1908. So far ahead of its time. It blew away all the other, but they were expensive. They were quite expensive, but they lasted forever. And let me show you something. There's like almost a dozen oil holes on here. Here's one. Here's one here on the bottom. Oil hole over here. You see that one there? Oil hole here. You just got to keep looking. Every shaft, every bearing position has an oil hole to it. So what I did is I flooded with the 50-50. That because what happens is the oil, or the years ago, it dries up, it gets cakey, and these are hard to operate. Now with the 50-50 bath we just gave it, and you can't be stingy with the 50-50, but look how smooth that is. Listen to it. That's just beautiful, isn't it? What a great thing. We're going to take this all apart, clean it up, but that's a good thing to do now to operate it, get it good with the 50-50. What a great drill. John, thanks so much.
Again, I'm sorry about going long on this one. I just want to say thank you so much again to everybody who sent anything into the show. Again, I appreciate it so much. Can't tell you. Thank you, and I hope you have a great day. Take care. Now enjoy your weekend. Bye-bye.